offensive rebound there. There was a ball that was available, and everyone was getting back on defense. Will Bynum.
Wow, you can't let him get that wide open, and Will Bynum drains one from the corner. It's 6-2.
Yeah, it's the hair.
It was always the hair that was the big factor in intimidation. Inside, wow. You mentioned B.J. Elder. And Greg, he has another hustle, threw it away. Muhammad saw that pass coming from about 5 miles away. And then he goes all the way to the bucket. No transition defense. And the Jayhawks are in deep trouble right now, Greg. It's 15-4, and KU has shown no sign of being able to score.
And C.J. Giles was open.
Will Bynum with a nice crossover. Will he get an assist? Yes, he will. Another very three from the outside. Jarrett Jack, it's 27-11. Good. And then he missed the layup.
And you're going to have Muhammad on the other end for a big one.
A monster jam for Muhammad after Aaron Miles gets all the way to the basket but can't finish with the left hand. And it's 31-15, which I believe ties the largest lead of this day.
No rotation.
Well, Jackson sets fit. He rolls Giddens fires. Got it. J.R. Giddens. Maybe that will get J.R. going.
And that was good defense by Muhammad. They're going to get a steal. And
playing point guard. Mulai out to J.R. He'll fire. Bang! J.R. Giddens. And we've got ourselves a 7-point game.
Penetration, penetration, penetration. Here's J.R. Giddens, the possession before, knocking down his second three of the night to get this lead down to 7. And Paul Hewitt, there he is, screaming for a timeout. And he
Giles, though, bails the Jayhawks out. Aaron Miles, he's got 2 today. Make it 3. Aaron Miles is 3-for-3 from long range. He shoots 55% on the season coming in from there. And on it, Moody comes away with it.
Got some numbers.
JR is spotting up, but Aaron's feeling it.
How about Aaron Miles stepping up big? He did not like the criticism last year. Take a look at it. There he is, just stopping on a dime on the fast break. Doesn't even hit the rim. Follows up Schinger's three, and there he is, 4-for-4 from the three.
He's got the holster ready, and he's going to fire here. Bang! Alex Galindo, and the Jayhawks are on fire from downtown. It's 45-43.
What did I talk about? I was only one assist away from Jock Vaughn. Alex Galindo pretty much out of bounds. Doesn't matter. He's a shooter. Foul will put both teams into the bonus.
It's foul number 3 on Morrow. Langford will not be denied. He got punched in the face, and Keith is hurt. He needs to check out. He may have gotten poked in the eye.
Poked in the eye or head. Something happened, but bottom line is Kansas is in within 1 point. Big time drive by Keith Langford going back to the well again. And yeah, he got swiped across the face right as he released that ball. And watch him just get smacked right here, right there. And that would have been difficult to call because it was a glancing blow, but
Kansas with probably not the best looks that it's had the last couple trips. Jack trying to take over, and he does it again. We've seen this before. Penetrate. 7 on the shot clock. Langford for 3, and he buries it. We've got ourselves a 1-point game. No doubt about that one. It was behind the line.
How about that? That was
Schinscher steps out. Miles is in trouble. Langford with 3. That would tie it. How about that one? We are tied at 61.
How about those home runs? 50 years at Allen Fieldhouse. Keith is happy for these runs.
Prayer.
Home rim prayer. Shot clock running down. No choice. Throw it up. Almost got fouled. The rims are kind.
Jayhawks, Yellow Jackets, tied at 61. Here we go. West has him. Spinning with 5. Langford for the win. It's short. Rebound to Schinscher. And guess what, folks? We are going to overtime.
What a ball game.
And we got an injury on Jack. Gets it into the corner. Muhammad slashing through the lane. And got it. And it's a 4-point lead. A 2-possession game now. And Kansas needs a timeout. The Jayhawks haven't done much here in overtime.
Haven't done anything.
He's going to go one-on-one with Will Bynum. How about Galindo? He's going to have to fire it.
Unbelievable. Oh. Unbelievable.
From Bill Self's lap, Alex Galindo. We thought he had a coming out party against Milwaukee. How about tonight?
A lot of those are launched because there's no Wayne. Langford has the steal. He's back in the game. JR for the lead. He got it.
Oh,
and for the first time, Kansas is on top.
All by Keith Langford on the defensive end. Let's take a look at this. Keith just gets his hands, gets his right hand out there, gets it to Aaron. Aaron gets it to JR. A little twist and turn in English with the kiss.
On the baseline, got it to Galindo. No whistle, but Langford's there. He's in the lane, and he gives the Jayhawks a one-point lead. Langford has 16.
That is just will and determination to keep Langford again. Let's see if they get a timeout.
I don't think you're going to get a timeout. What's there to discuss? Get it to your senior and end this thing right now.
And go towards the basket. No fadeaways.
West guarding Langford in the lane to win. Bang! Keith Langford, 2 seconds left. Georgia Tech has time.
Still time on the clock. Don't celebrate too much. Georgia Tech's going to have 2 seconds to get a shot up. But how about Keith Langford with the bucket? And J.R. Gittins jawing a little bit with Muhammad. Bill Self get control of this team and calm them down. There's still 2 seconds. Keith Langford first. Not a whole lot there. He just creates. Pivots, rises up. With the little touch over the rim. I don't know what else you do. Good defense that time by Georgia Tech. Keith just made a big time shot. And the bench goes wild. Now they can't celebrate too much. Again, there is 2 seconds. Got to wipe that one away and make sure you knock this one down to guarantee at the worst the tie.
And he missed it. Now Georgia Tech has 1 second to go the length of the court. That one's going to come up short. And Kansas comes from behind after being down by 16 and wins it, Greg. Unbelievable game here today.
What a fun game. That was unbelievable. Two of the best college basketball teams in the country playing their hearts out. Kansas had every reason to fold up shop and go home. They fight back after an abysmal 10 minutes in that first half. And huge victory for Bill Self and the Kansas Jayhawks.